said the last drink was the last drink. You make it hard to leave. Bonjour à tous. Hello everybody. Welcome to my channel. I'm very happy that you are here. There are so many good restaurants and a lot of choices of great food in Paris. There also are very good street food options in Paris, just like other big cities. They are convenient eats that you can consume immediately. Some of them are French, but a lot of street foods in Paris are international. I'll tell you why. Traditional French food is not fast food. They are not usually made to be cooked quickly enough to be served fast. Formal French meals come in multiple courses and are lengthy affairs. 7-course French dinner starts with l'apéritif, aperitif, followed by l'entrée, appetizer, le plat principal, main course, le fromage, cheese, le dessert, dessert, le café, coffee, and finishes with le digestif, digestif. Excluding alcoholic beverage and coffee, there are 4 courses. Even French school canteens typically serve 4-course lunch: vegetable starter, warm main dish, cheese, and dessert. Most street foods à la française or French-style fast foods are predominantly from boulangerie, where you can buy fresh baked goods. That's why international foods that can be made in advance or slowly all day became popular fast street foods in France. Whether they are French or international, there are reasons why they are popular. It's because they are delicious and convenient. Let me show you these yummy street food options in Paris. Let's go! Allons-y! Jambon beurre is a very typical and common sandwich in any boulangerie in Paris, probably the most popular baguette sandwich. It's so French and good. As I said in my must-try food in Paris video, French butter is just so delicious and tastes great in this sandwich. Jambon, usually thin sliced cooked ham and often a slice of cheese inserted in a buttered short baguette together, it becomes a nice street food. There's nothing falling from the sandwich, so it's easy to eat. Guabao is a type of steamed bun originated from Fujian province, China, and is a popular snack in many South Asian countries and in France as well. Various types of stewed meat and condiments are stuck in between steamed bread that is semi-circular and flat in form. Guabao fillings are mostly savory, balancing out the slight sweetness in steamed bun. Probably pork is the most common ingredient. And the steamed bun, called lotus leaf bun, is very soft and slightly sweet. So you will taste salty and sweet taste at the same time, and it's quite addictive. It's a good takeout food as well. Coque Monsieur is a warm sandwich you can easily find on the menu at a casual restaurant, but you can also buy one at any boulangerie in Paris. They would ask you if you want it to be reheated. And yes, please ask to heat it for you. It's so much tastier when it is eaten warm. Fillings of Coque Monsieur are bechamel sauce, ham, and Gruyère or Comté cheese. Also, the sandwich can be topped with melted cheese. It's delectable. Banh mi is a Vietnamese version of soup sandwich. In Paris, bread similar to baguette is used for banh mi. There is a large Vietnamese population in Paris. That's probably why you can find a lot of Vietnamese restaurants and grocery stores in Paris.
Unlike traditional French baguette sandwiches, more vegetables are put in banh mi. At banh mi places, a few different types of combo meals often are offered. You can combine a banh mi and a couple of nems. Nem is known as spring rolls, fry rolls, or Vietnamese imperial rolls. Nems are usually made of either minced pork or prawns, wrapped in rice wrappers and deep fried. Banh mi with a couple of nems makes a full meal that are served fast, and you don't need any cutleries. Quiche is a French savory tart. The most well-known quiche must be quiche Lorraine. The dish is originated in the eastern French region Lorraine that borders three countries, Germany, Belgium, and Luxembourg. Quiche is filled with the savory ingredients such as cheese, meat, jambon, seafood, or vegetables added into savory custard made of egg and thick cream. As it consists of all the tasty ingredients, it's scrumptious. You can buy a slice or a small round quiche at any boulangerie in Paris and France. Quiche may be served hot, warm, or cold. I love it. Döner kebab is a type of kebab cooked on a vertical rotisserie. Turkish immigrants brought döner kebab to France, where it became very popular. Döner kebab is the third most popular fast food in France, next to hamburgers and pizza. There are more than 10,000 kebab shops spread over the country, so you can find it literally everywhere. A typical kebab consists of Turkish flatbread stuffed with the döner seasoned meat shavings, lettuce, sliced tomato and onions, and a choice of sauce including sauce blanche, which is a mayo yogurt sauce. In France, kebabs are usually served with French fries, sometimes stuffed into the bread itself. Kebab is the ultimate eat-on-the-go food. Marinated in spices, the meat is delicious. I really like it, especially with French fries à la française on the side. Okay, I would say that these are some of the most common fast food or street foods in Paris. Oh, also, I'd like to show you an attractive eatery place. Marché des Enfants Rouges is a 17th century covered market where so many stalls sell multicultural eateries. It is the oldest covered market in France, established in 1628. The market is located in the 3rd arrondissement in Paris, and it has been listed as a historic monument since 1982. It is a 400-year-old farmer's market that offers fresh fruits, vegetables, flowers, cheese, and bread, but is now more specialized in international ready-to-eat foods like Moroccan, Italian, Japanese, Lebanese, and many more. It's a very popular eatery market where you can find all sorts of savory treats. You will love it. That's all for today. I hope you liked it. I hope to see you again next week. If you have enjoyed it, please do give this video a thumbs up. I would very much appreciate it. Please subscribe if you want to see more of my weekly videos. Thanks for watching.